Turkesterone does not work, at least according to a new study. Hi, I'm Dr. Jim Stoppani, and welcome to my YouTube channel. I'll be covering topics on training, nutrition, supplementation, and anything else my subscribers want to know. If you find this information useful, don't forget to like, share, and comment below. And don't forget to subscribe so that you can be notified when I post new videos. Turkesterone does not work, at least according to a new study. Turkesterone is a phytoecdysteroid, which is a plant as well as an insect anabolic hormone. It's basically testosterone for plants and insects. Phytoecdysterones are made from cholesterol, just like testosterone is. So the structure of turkesterone and other ecdysterones is very similar to the structure of testosterone. So you can see why some people believe that turkesterone may provide similar benefits in strength and muscle mass as testosterone does, but without the negative side effects that comes from taking testosterone. The plant that turkesterone is typically extracted from for use in supplements is Ajuga turkestanica, which is native to Central Asia. In this new study from Dr. Joey Antonio and team from Nova Southeastern University, 31 young, healthy, and active men and women took either 500 milligrams of turkesterone per day or a placebo for 4 weeks without changing their typical diet or exercise habits. Using DEXA scans taken before and after the 4 weeks to measure body composition, the researchers reported that there were no differences in muscle mass or body fat in either group. Although they didn't assess turkesterone's ability to increase muscle strength, they did conclude that taking 500 milligrams of turkesterone per day was not effective at increasing muscle mass or decreasing body fat. Of course, the one thing missing from the study was a structured weight training program. So although the study suggests that turkesterone does not increase muscle mass or decrease body fat, at least at a dose of 500 milligrams per day, it may have been because the subjects weren't training sufficiently to see a change. And the other question is, what about a higher dose? If 500 milligrams of turkesterone was ineffective, how about doubling that, maybe to 1,000 milligrams per day? Would a higher dose be effective? Since this is the first legitimate study published on turkesterone in humans, at least that I'm aware of, it's hard to say just how effective turkesterone may be until there's more research done. But the only way to truly know may be to try it for yourself. If you do, let me know what you experienced or didn't experience from taking turkesterone.